Now that ANSYS has calculated the displacements at the pins by generating the necessary algebraic equations through potential energy minimization, let's move to post-processing. In static structural problems, the first thing in post-processing that I tend to look at is the deformed shape of the structure, because we human beings have an intuitive feel for, how a structure should deform when it's, fixed at some point and pulled in other locations. I've seen students, the only thing they look at is the 1 meter stress, which is an extremely abstract quantity, and you don't even know if you've defined your displacement constraints correctly. So let's take a look at the deformed shape. And before I do that, let me briefly go back to my pet, what's inside or under the black box. Okay, so based on the user inputs, ANSYS has figured out, our mathematical model is based on, finding the nodal or pin displacements such that the potential energy of the truss is minimized, and then it did the numerical solution, generated the algebraic equations, and it calculated selected variables at selected points. And the selected variables are, at least the ones we care about, are ux and uy at the three selected points. And we're moving on to post-processing, but one thing to keep in mind is that everything that we're doing here is coming from those six displacements. Okay, so ux, uy at these three nodes. Let me go into ANSYS. I'll highlight solution in the tree, and I'll say deformation total. Okay, that'll add a total deformation object under the tree, and then I can select solve, but I prefer to select evaluate all results to remind myself that this is just post-processing. That's ANSYS, lingo for basically this is coming from the nodal displacements. Okay, and you might not have the wireframe turned on, so you might see something like this. And I like to go in and turn on the undeformed wireframe. Okay, so this is where the original midlines were, and these are the new midlines. And note that this is exaggerated. So if I do it to true scale, I don't see the deformation. So, because of the small displacements. But on the computer, you can exaggerate or super exaggerate. So this is all the displacements exaggerated by a factor of 350. And we can check that the displacement constraints are honored. Okay, so this pin hasn't moved in X or Y. This pin hasn't moved in Y. And then this has moved to the right, and a little bit down, and that makes sense because the force is applied over here. And the magnitude's the other thing, so we can figure out, okay, did this move the way we expected it to? Is it constrained where we want it to be constrained? All those look right. What about the magnitude of the displacements? Okay, this is about the order of 10 to the power of minus 4, which is in the same ballpark as what we saw in our pre-analysis. So in the pre-analysis, we said, oh, the displacements are going to be of the order of 5, 10 to the power of minus 5. So this is, in that ballpark. That means that the order of the magnitude of the displacements is also plausible, which probably means we gave it the right material properties, because if you give it the wrong material properties, often the displacements would be in the wrong ballpark. So let's next move on to probing the displacements, and there are a couple of ways you can do this that I wanted to show you.